you know you wear it inside. Run away with all your lies, run away in your disguise. You know you don't fool me. You blame me for your boredom. You blame me for your pain.
Well, hello and welcome back to Paul Mash TV. I'm Paul Mash. And we got a great show coming up for you in a minute here. So, well, before I do, I just want to thank you once again for all your letters and words of encouragement, and we appreciate that. And if you want your chance to get heard and email me and talk to me, there's several ways you could do it. You can go to facebook.com/PaulMashTV. Be sure to like the page, and you can talk to us on there. You can follow me on Instagram.com/PaulMashTVOfficial. So I hope you'll do that. You can also email me, capital P, lowercase M-A-S-H-T-V, all one word, at gmail.com. And we'll always respond to you, and we'll see what we can do for you to help you. And if you're on YouTube right now, click that subscribe button right there, and you'll keep up with all the latest episodes when they become available. So we hope you'll do that too. So we hope we hear from you then. Right now from Summerfield, Florida, we have J. Allen 6. And I think you're really going to like this gentleman. And he's a very talented country music singer, just like all of our artists here on the show. So we'll get to that in just a minute. But here's a quick ad from Click Jam. Don't go away.
Does anyone know where Lou is? Anyone? Let's jam.
Well, hello again, everybody. It's time for another interview, and with us from Summerfield, Florida, we have J. Allen 6. Thanks for joining us, Jay.
Hey, no problem. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem. And we're glad that you decided to join us and talk with us. One question I like to ask around here is a lot of people have their own story, so why don't you tell me a little bit about how you decided to become a musician. Have you always wanted to be a musician? Did you fall into it? I mean, let's hear your story, though.
Well, it's kind of interesting because I sang for years and years in church, and my brother and I used to, it's been about 10 years ago, but we did a lot of Southern gospel in church. But my wife and I have been married for 29 years, and we have 7 boys. And so music always had to take a back seat to making a living. So for the last 30 years or so, I've been in the jewelry business as a jeweler. And somebody last year, there's a local venue here called the Orange Blossom Opry. They have a live band, and you can go in and sing with the live band. And for a year, they hounded me, man, you need to sing with them. You need to sing with them. So last July, I got up the courage to go sing, and it just all of a sudden, all that old singing that I used to do came back. And I'm like, you know, this is just, I love this. And so I just really started to pursue it again. And that's how I got to where I am right now. So.
Oh, well, that's good.
I'm kind of late getting into the game, you know, as really pursuing it. But I've been having a blast for the last year or so, you know, really going after it.
Well, that's good. I'm glad that you're doing it and having a good time with it. And what would say some of your influences as far as professional music goes? Do you have any bands that stick out in your mind?
Well, I really enjoy, and it's probably cliche, but I really enjoy George Jones. Of course, probably everybody does. It's in country music. But George Jones, Johnny Cash, I grew up listening to that. And more modern now, I'm a big Trace Atkins fan. And a lot of that is just because of his voice fits my voice so well. So I really have all kinds of genres. When I first got into my work, I grew up listening to, by the time I was 17, for 5 or 6 years every day, classic rock. So, you know, I know Bob Seger and Creedence Clearwater Revival and all those people. So, all that kind of forms. I do like upbeat music, but I get stuck singing more melancholy country. I still enjoy a country ballad. It really just gets me. So, I guess I have the whole gamut of influences to what kind of shapes what I sing and what I enjoy.
Oh, okay. Well, of course, I know you don't know this, but I'm in all kind of genres, you know. I mean, there's not a genre I don't really like, anything from rock, country, whatever. So it's good to be at times diversified, but it's not a big deal if you're only a kind of a solo thing either. So, and, you know, genre, so it all works there, I guess. Have you had any albums on in the past, or would you like to do albums? Maybe you talk a little bit.
I want to. You know, we've been talking about that, and funny because I've been having a conversation just this last week about making an album, and I've got a good friend of mine that's been in the industry, the business, for about 40 years, and so he's kind of given me the ins and outs of what I need to do and what I should or shouldn't do. So I'm kind of anxious to move forward that. So I've got a lot of help and a lot of friends kind of pushing me toward that. So I'm real anxious to maybe find some original music. That's what I really want to at least put, two, three, four original songs on there, and maybe some songs that have been out before. But I do like to find those gems that maybe were released, but maybe weren't number one songs, but still when you hear them, you're like, wow, that's a great country song. So that's sort of what I'm looking to do. So hopefully we can get something done here in the coming months with an album.
Okay. Well, I'm sure everybody would love to hear that. As a matter of fact, I know that, I love the music so far. And speaking of that, we're getting ready to play a song from you in just a few minutes here. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about that and if there's a story behind it.
There is a story. Again, it's a Trace Atkins song. Mm-hmm. And I think it maybe went to 14 on the charts, so it wasn't like one of his big hits. But it talks about pretty much it could be autobiographical. You know, like I said, I've been married for 29 years, and we have 7 boys in that 29-year period. And what I thought was important when I was 17, 18, before I was married, now, you know, those things shift. So in the song, it kind of describes, you know, at the beginning, it's always about what pickup truck or pretty girl. Mm-hmm. And then it changed real quick when his wife gets pregnant. And then now, you know, it's all about, I hope the kids are safe when he hears the sirens, or, you know, when that phone call, you know, there's a storm heading and you can't be there. So that song kind of hits home with me, and it's everything that, you know, I have adult children now, and they're in their late 20s. And in the video, one of my sons and my daughter-in-law is in there, and my wife at the end with my 3 granddaughters. So that song sort of has a lot to do with anybody that sees the video at the end. Those are my granddaughters from my oldest son, and my wife's walking in there. So that song really kind of speaks about my life, so I can definitely relate to that song. That's why it makes it.
Okay. Well, I think that's all I really need for now. Jane, I appreciate you coming on the show.
I appreciate you having me. That's great. I appreciate you taking the time.
Yeah, we'd love to have you back sometime. If you ever have anything new to plug, maybe we'll have you back on sometime.
All right.
And we'll go ahead and play that song now, All I Ask For Anymore, by J6, and we'll do that right now, so don't go away.
was a home run when the game was tied. A pickup truck when I could drive. One pink line when Melissa says I'm late. It was a passing grade, a pretty girl. All the money in the world. What mattered then kept changing every day. But when I bow my head tonight, there'll be no me, myself, and I. Just watch my wife and kids win, Lord. That's all I ask for anymore. Nowadays it's crazy how passing storm, a siren sound, make me drop it all and pick up the phone. To hear her say that all's okay, it's all I need to know these days. Can't wait to see their faces when I get home. Little man.